got it. Thank you.
Want this way?
Regarding that movie, The Dollars of Purpose, you seen
the video? The what?
The Dollars of Purpose.
No, okay, I'm coming.
There was a video going out now on TMZ and Fox.
I don't
the
want to.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. But it's a mystery. Oh, no, no.
All right, there we go.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Spreading in a way only PETA can.
A nearly nude PETA protester lying down on a big plate.
178 animals seized from a rescue. The difference in how the animals look now is day and night.
We're on tour going to different cities helping
people make the connection that the meat on their plate was once an animal with feelings and a will to live.
Portland has been named the most vegan-friendly city in the U.S. by Paul McCartney and PETA.
According to PETA, beer is better for you than milk.
People are seeing that it's meant to tell them the story behind meat production and walking away from it.
PETA released a video of employees at Culver's upon killing ducks in extremely disturbing ways.
PETA pressuring lawmakers to stop allowing restaurants to serve
live animals.
We're here to bust the myths about
protein! Protein!
Yeah, but all the voice in your mind and in your heart that makes you curious about being vegan is something you should listen to.
It'll grow on you.
Anything with the central nervous system can suffer, and we just shouldn't be involved in anything that contributes to suffering.
No more make coats for Armani. The famous designer is going fur-free.
He's on vegan.
PETA's investigation prompted Global Brands Group to ban ostrich skin and feathers from all its brands.
PETA is exposing some horrible facts behind down feathers.
There's nothing fashionable about it.
There are so many alternatives these days.
No life deserves to be taken away just for fashion.
Animals have feelings just like us. If you're an animal lover, you will realize that.
It's all about education and having a heart.
The only option is to not use wool.
There is no happy place for it to go.
PETA denounced what they said was a cruel treatment of sheep and lambs in southern Chile.
Clothing giant Gap and the Peoples have stopped selling fur after pressure from PETA.
A group of high school students using cat intestines as a jump rope.
PETA is sounding off about the video. I'm speechless. That's...
They're learning probably never to do that again.
PETA pushed Congress to phase out the use of animals in military trauma training.
We're taking more power than we're taking in this area. And we're going to win.
PETA scientists assist Netherlands in its vow to end animal testing nationwide.
The PETA International Science Consortium has been awarded the prestigious Lush Training Prize.
Less than 24 hours after PETA launched an online campaign pushing Johnson & Johnson to stop using live animals for companies agreed.
9,000 animals are spared from agonizing chemical tests after PETA submits information to the FDA.
PETA is handling the passage of a landmark bill as the beginning of the end for animal use and chemical testing.
Rush University Medical Center is going virtual. PETA is paying for half of the training, so...
The news warning of many chimpanzees who are kept behind bars against their will. This is absolutely unforgivable, and it really has to stop.
Joe was imprisoned here, in the squalid cage of this decrepit roadside zoo, for 17 years. He was confined to a tiny, rusted cage, isolated and alone. Joe was finally released, and with the help of Save the Chimp Sanctuary, we were able to take him to his wonderful new home.
PETA also helped to retire Lisa Marie and Tarzan from solitary confinement. They were taken to Save the Chimp Sanctuary, where they have acres of land to roam, play, and interact with their own.
If I switch my eye on, okay, just put it on. Oh! Director, hold,
hold! Get it out of here! Get it! Hold up! Yo!
Ringling Brothers plans to retire its elephants from the circus.
The new protests from PETA. Hospital will no longer offer trip packages to places where travelers can ride elephants.
TripAdvisor is going to stop selling tickets to animal abusive attractions.
violating the Endangered Species Act.
PETA used this investigation footage to expose heartbreaking cruelty in Chinese circuses.
Mired in controversy and drowning in debt, the Bowmanville Zoo is closing. The zoo is blaming controversial video posted by animal rights group PETA.
Alec Baldwin is calling on the government to shut down bear pits.
As long as well-meaning people continue to go to roadside zoos and shows, they will continue to be safe.
I was rescued in my new home. I get to be me. I get to be a bear.
It is the end of an era. The Baltimore National Aquarium said they will be soon freeing their celebrity dolphins.
PETA are challenging their captivity with
PETA. They're confined in small tanks. The most horrific thing is like living in a bathtub for the rest of our lives.
The battle between SeaWorld and PETA continues.
38 protesters each held a sign with the name of an orca that has died at SeaWorld.
SeaWorld will start phasing out its killer whale shows in San Diego.
Lily Tomlin wants people to think twice about supporting SeaWorld.
I can't help it. I'm a member of PETA.
When people are amused or entertained, they have an opportunity to think twice about an issue.
I work at SeaWorld. It's not my job to think.
When PETA found Koa, he was beaten so badly that he'd lost an ear. But with emergency surgery and time to recover, he finally found the loving family he deserves.
PETA released a video of a so-called hamster mill.
PetSmart and Petco have stopped business with the company following federal citations.
PETA's expose revealed the systemic cruelty of the hermit crab tree.
When devastating flooding in Louisiana forced thousands of people out of their homes, many had to leave their family and pets behind. So volunteers are stepping up the care.
We are here today to receive roughly 60 animals who have been rescued in Louisiana.
We have not time, huh? Well, you're not going to have one anymore.
Animal activists braved frigid temperatures. One PETA volunteer sat outside of City Hall for 12 hours.
PETA actually teamed up with the Broncos quarterback Chris Harris to show just how cold it can get for dogs outside this time of year.
All my dogs are spayed and neutered. That's the first thing you have to do.
Spaying and neutering pets controls pet population. And also, there's so many dogs that need homes.
When you see a dog like me, please speak up, because we can't. We're counting on you.
PETA hosted an adopt-a-thon in Norfolk's Bee Park this afternoon.
We've always adopted rescue dogs. He's going to be living in Beverly,
wouldn't he? Better than me, probably.
PETA fielded more than 15,000 cruelty complaints, built and delivered more than 300 free dog houses, and sterilized more than 15,000 cats and dogs.
Thank God for PETA and all the great work.
PETA had worked for suffering animals in 20 countries. Nearly 30,000 schools received PETA's Share the World curriculum pack to help teachers instill the importance of kindness to all.
Animal rights will happen if we try, and we try hard. So please, do everything you can possibly think of to do all the time. Thank you very, very much.
Please join me in welcoming tonight's hosts, Pamela Anderson and Mary Matalin.
President Eisenhower, who signed the Humane Slaughter Act in 1958, and Democrat President Johnson, who signed the Animal Welfare Act in 1965.
Nixon signed the Endangered Species Act, and Clinton is the first president who ended up vegan.
So he says. He's been in our house many times.
Wait, please no. I've seen him at vegan restaurants in LA.
He's, okay, let's just say, an occasional crawfish etouffee has been seen to pass his body people. But he philosophically is a vegan. Okay. So also, President Bush's, we're big dog lovers. We always had them roaming around the West Wing. In fact, President Bush 43, literally trained Barney, that little rascal, to nip at the heels of all the women and rip our pantyhose. So we all continue to love him. So that's the Bushes. And our current incoming Donald Trump fired a cruel mule diving act.
Yeah, do you know? It's crazy.
I should have read this earlier.
Yeah.
I thought it was mule driving. It's a mule diving act.
Mule dive off something into a tiny pool. But he made it stop. Trump made it stop.
Who would be even into that anyway? I don't think he should get credit for that. We need to ask President like Trump to do more.
Yes.
More for PETA, because even against mules diving, that's a no-brainer, right? Okay, sorry. This is awesome.
Okay, now please welcome my favorite president, PETA's Ingrid
Pamela
actress is making headlines, but not for her latest movie role. She's a crusader for animal rights.
Pam's narrating a new video for PETA.
We can have a look at that killer without killing anything.
Pamela Anderson is meeting lawmakers of the French Parliament to support legislation banning strong rock.
We've spoken to President Putin too, but for us to have us into Russia, it's nice to speak with very powerful people and get things done.
PETA's honorary director helped pass Europe's strongest animal protection law in Austria.
Pamela Anderson fighting to end cockfighting in New Mexico.
The actress is promoting the first all-vegetarian meal in the U.S. jail system.
I often look out for the beautiful ocean in which the whales can find its sea world had freedom.
Just try and make little changes all the time, and eventually you end up, you know, doing great things.
Please welcome PETA's World Ambassador for Animal Rights, Pamela Anderson.
But let's take a quick look at what your support has made possible in the past year alone. Where's the monkey? Oh, there he is. For 3 decades, baby monkeys were subjected to maternal deprivation experiments at the NIH. But last year, PETA got them ended forever. The NIH had also been warehousing 360 chimpanzees for experiments. Some sat in cages for decades. But after massive pressure from PETA and others, they are all going to be climbing trees instead of cage bars because they are being retired. And PETA doesn't forget the millions of smaller animals and the rats and mice who have chemicals poured down their throats. Now that PETA has passed major chemical testing reforms, is the beginning of the end of animal poisoning tests. To accomplish these achievements, PETA had the help of many members of Congress, and tonight we're celebrating a few of those heroes. Mary will tell you about them in a minute, but first I want to tell you something about Mary. She's helped PETA get elephants out of circuses, get monkeys out of labs, stop SeaWorld from breeding orcas, and now she's helping PETA stop the use of animals in military training. As if all this weren't enough, take a look at this video.
Americans of all political persuasions are coming together to support law enforcement for animals killed for food.
The Republican political consultant Mary Matalin is making a videotaped appeal to Indiana's lawmakers to vote against a bill that would ban unapproved videos on farms.
More of us should recognize that people have really started to think about what they eat and where it comes from. My friends at PETA went undercover at sprawling turkey warehouses in West Virginia and found workers beating and stomping on birds.
There is no government inspection of factory farms for cruelty violations. Workers who report abuse are often ignored. I want animals on farms to be treated in accordance with the law.
He does not like when I bring my pet rats on my shoulders to cook dinner. Can you imagine that? Okay, so I'm glad we're all kumbaya getting along here. So. Really, I didn't know, Dan, you were going to do that. My involvement with PETA is thanks to Dan Matthews. He's a genius. And did all the ag-gag work. I just show up and do whatever he says to do. So you know what all of that we have accomplished here, he has accomplished, and Ingrid and PETA has accomplished. And they also, this is more good news, I just learned this myself tonight, won the lawsuit against the state of Idaho, which meant for the first time ever a court declared the ag-gag law unconstitutional. There's something that everybody, okay? All right, what else? Similar, PETA's also instituted similar lawsuits in 18 other states, and in 3 other states, and in 18 states, they've prevented these kinds of bills ever even getting to the governor's desk. So PETA, and you contributors to PETA, that's how it works. So, we're going to give some awards now, but can I say before we give the official awards, awards to all of you. This doesn't happen by accident. It doesn't happen without support. Money is important, but spreading the word and awareness is really, really important. And most people shut their eyes to what we, including myself, I can barely look at this, but it is imperative that we continue doing the awareness, and you're doing it, and we engage people on both sides of the aisles, because that's the way not just to bring us together, but to do what we should be doing and we're meant to do in God's eyes. Okay. Sorry, a little ad-lib there, Dan. Like, Dan doesn't trust me. He's back there sweating. Okay, Dan. Okay, now, tonight's awardees and how they've helped animals throughout their careers, right? Congressman Sheila Jackson Lee, I can't see. Are you here? Sheila Jackson Lee of Texas, you know that. 22 years of animal protection bills. Now, you want to hear the panoply of this is amazing. She's worked to ban animal fighting, stop the primate trade, end the dog meat trade in China, yeah. Strengthen protections for threatened species. She also was a pioneer in publicizing the link between, this is what I'm referencing, it's so critical for everybody. The link between violence against animals and violence against people. Yeah. Yeah. She also has a day job. Congressman Dan Donovan, see? New York. I got a daughter in upstate New York. She's marching on tomorrow, so. Okay, I have another daughter who's not marching. Highly opinionated. I don't know where those two get it. Congressman Donovan has co-sponsored a bill to end. Actually, both my daughters of opposite political views are into this. Thank you. Once time, they're not going to think of a loser. To herald you for support for co-sponsoring the bill to end cosmetic testing on animals. And, okay, this one I don't even know about. Like, what kind of world do we live in? Strengthen the ban on animal torture pornography known as crush videos. I'm never gonna yell at my husband again. That was like, no, that's, thank you. Like, who does that shit? Pennsylvania Congressman Ryan Castell, I know you're with it. Here. Dan, there's so many, there's like, thank you all for doing everything you do that if you're like a person in the real world, you don't even know this is going on and you're making it not happen. So thank you, Congress, people, everyone. Congressman Costello supported legislation to stop horses from being slaughtered for human consumption. Protecting animals in domestic violence cases. My friends and I, who are here tonight from Louisiana, who we at Katrina, we saved our animals before we saved ourselves, whatever they were. So the notion that there is domestic violence on animals is very near and dear to us. So we're, thank you for all this connection. Congressman Costello also helped pass a law to remove chemical testing standards away from cruel, ineffective tests on animals. Thank you. So, our honor, your honor, and with your permission, it's now time to present each of these legislators with PETA's Congressional Leadership Award. Please come to the stage. Thank you.
Throw a cat off a nine-story roof because he was angry at his fiance.
Well, I can proudly tell you that that man spent the next 4 years in prison. And if that didn't teach him a lesson, I'm sure the guys upstate in New York taught him a lesson too, and they already did. When I thought about tonight, I thought about how God in his infinite wisdom gave his beautiful creatures defense mechanisms to protect themselves from their common, their natural enemies. He gave them strength to withstand the attacks of their aggressors. He gave them the ability to camouflage themselves from their predators. He gave them the ability to outrun their pursuers. And then I thought about what did he do to give them protection against their unnatural enemies, mankind. He gave us PETA. You continue to do what you're doing for God's creatures, and Sheila Ryan and our colleagues will continue to do that in college. Thank you very much.
You have just started something. In Congress, you need co-sponsors and you need co-conspirators, if you will. And so from Texas to New York to Pennsylvania, you just put three co-conspirators together to fight for PETA in the new Congress. Allow me to thank you all and to mention Ingrid, what a dynamic president, and I'm glad she's telling the White House what to do. And I hope she will be in line to do that this time around. I want to thank Pam for her passion and for her talent. Pam Anderson, give her a very big hand. And since we're in a political town, let me give truthful accolades to Mary. She is bright, astute, analytical, and she knows how to disagree and not be disagreeable. She needs to be part of the healing process as we go forward. Thank you, Mary, for so much. Animals have rights, and animals have rights because we have laws. And in order to have laws, PETA has to continue its conscience-driven advocacy. Don't you ever turn around, give up, give out, or give in. Thank you, PETA. I am very proud to have championed animal rights for a very long time, a member of the caucus in the House. But I guess my most devastating moment was to watch the ongoing story about Cecil the lion. Only an example of the stories that have been told by my friends and colleagues. We could have told the story about the brutality of the Russian brown bear run over by a truck and then clobbered to death. And Cecil the lion was right here for all the world to see. For someone who takes care of human beings to come and say, I didn't know what the law was or that he was famous. He was a living, breathing creature. Oh, how beautiful Cecil was. Then to add to the conspiracy, Cecil finds himself brought to the United States. Not lively and thriving, if you consider that part of saving animals to bring them here. No, lost in a brutal, what is perceived to be entertainment. Cecil the Lion lost his life. So I introduced legislation to amend the Endangered Species Act, but really, we can spend all year amending it because there are a lot of loopholes to not allow trophy and animal heads, if I might say, to be brought into the United States. We're going to keep fighting for that legislation. For it provides important as I close. I chair the Congressional Children's Caucus. It is very clear that when children are allowed, brought up, or in such atmosphere that they see the abuse of animals, it is well documented that it translates to their life as adults. That means that PETA now has even a more enhanced cause, that we stop the violence against animals from the very beginning when children begin to understand what it is to be a little human being and to be able to share and to give and to protect. I look forward to PETA educating little people in schools across America to be able to give to them the good things about animals. I love my dogs. I'm trying to get dogs into the home of my daughter's 18-month-old twins. You can imagine she's saying, can you hold up a little bit? Puppies, of course. But it begins at that early age. And so I close by saying this is a week that many of us, this nation, honored a man that truly believed in the beloved community. As I look at all of you and look to this week or tomorrow, I'm hoping that this beloved community, Republicans and Democrats, can be the calling card of America. But one of the things he said is that we should not look to be socially acceptable, politic, and respected, and not accept the criticism. For if you do what is right by your conscience, then that is all anyone can ask of you, that you do right, because it is the right thing to do. PETA, I am grateful that you are part of the beloved community, and as well, you are disrespecting openly, being politic, being socially accepted in some instances, and simply doing what is right because it is right. God bless all of you. God bless PETA. God bless the United States of America.
Please welcome back Mary Matalin.
Thank you. Dan, I'm going off script again. Don't freak out.
What a great way to kick off this inaugural with this, like,
if we can't come together on this issue, these issues, these compositive issues, thank you, Congress people. It's not made the force be with you, it's go forth and prosper. Okay. All right, shall I? So, if you want to dance, which is following this, we are now going to honor in absentia, or recognize in absentia other PETA people, PETA legislators. Starting with, not here, unfortunately, although it is pretty hard to get here. He may be out there wandering around the streets, you know. They had us all run by dogs. We'd get here faster, but instead of Congressman Earl Blumenauer of Oregon, co-chairs Congressional Animal Protection Caucus. So for those of you amongst us who thinks Congress has too much to do, or does too much, I'm happy there's a Congressional Animal Protection Caucus. Not only did he help PETA rescue 7 polar bears, thank you, from a circus, he also increased funding for anti-cruelty laws, law enforcement, and tightened restrictions on animal testing. Also not with us tonight, but doing yeoman's work, Congresswoman Dina Titus of Nevada has pushed to stop dog leather imports from China. Thank you, Councilman. And end the use of animals in military training. She was also the very first member of Congress to do a live telephone town hall for PETA. Thank you. So So they're not with us tonight, but we love them, we support them, and they have sent for us their video messages. Thank you all before we show this video. Thank you, thank you. Keep supporting it. Your friends will support, your neighbors will support across the country, and love each other.
Good evening. I'm very sorry that I can't be with you in person tonight. I'm deeply honored by this recognition, but even more, I welcome your partnership in the fight to protect animals. How we treat animals is intrinsically linked to how we treat each other. We have a moral obligation to our fellow creatures. There should be zero tolerance for animal abuse or cruelty in our society. Fortunately, in my experience, animal welfare is a unifying issue on Capitol Hill, and we've been able to make significant progress. I'm committed to continuing bipartisan support for animal protection in this new session of Congress. Your advocacy is important now more than ever. In a dysfunctional political environment, animal welfare may be one of the rare examples of bipartisan, non-ideological accomplishment that we will see. Thank you for all that you do. Working together, we will continue to advance policies to improve the welfare of animals while we work to bring people together rather than divide them. And again, thank you not just for this award, but for your commitment, passion, and hard work on behalf of our common cause for animals.
Hello, I'm Dina Titus of Nevada's 1st Congressional District. I wish I could thank you in person for the Congressional Leadership Award and share a champagne toast with you to celebrate the good work we've all done together to protect animals. Animal protection has become a household issue in the United States and an important priority in Congress thanks to the work of PETA. Like many of you in the audience, this is an area that has captivated me for my whole life. We've had many animal pets over the years, and they are integral members of our family. Most have been adopted, including Coco the squirrel monkey and Sadie the burrow, and lots of dogs and cats in between. Their memories are close to my heart, and they inspire me. These precious animals have taught me that if we are doing good things for animals, we're also doing good things for humans and for the whole planet. So thank you again for your courageous efforts, and please continue to count on me as an advocate and a friend. I look forward to seeing what we can accomplish next. Thank you very much.
And now, a brilliant broadcaster with a huge heart. This video will give you some idea of her strong voice for animals.
Tonight, a victory on a story we first brought to national attention on this show with the help of People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals.
This is an issue that begs for your attention this holiday season. Every year, millions are spent on store-bought dogs, and most of those dogs, experts say, come from puppy mills.
Russell Simmons has a message for the mayor. Live up to your promise to ban carriage horses now, or there will be consequences next election.
A groundbreaking lawsuit by PETA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, says animals should be protected by the Constitution.
And full disclosure, I am a card-carrying member of People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals.
Jean Velez Mitchell.
Hello, what a great night, huh? This is fun. Actually, it feels like a therapy session for me. I mean, I feel hopeful about the world, right?
They just want to live in peace and harmony, so we can learn something from them. Tonight, I was delighted to meet another state legislator who has done so much for animals, Maryland State Delegate Aruna Miller. She is in the house. Aruna, stand up. Where are you? Now, there she is. Stand up. Oh, she had to go, but we chatted. She's a wonderful person, a lot of fun. You know, Mary and Pamela are absolutely right. Animal protection is truly a rare bipartisan issue. And PETA learned that very early on. Back in the 80s, PETA's exposés of laboratories led to pivotal improvements to the Animal Welfare Act, spearheaded by Republican Senator Bob Dole, and those of you might remember Congressman Bob Dornan and Senator Bob Smith. They both of them fought passionately to pass animal protection bills. They helped PETA do everything, shut down a government dog lab, cut federal subsidies to the fur industry, and they helped get elephants out of the circus! And now we've got fur wildlings! Thanks to PETA. And make no mistake, that was PETA at work. Now, let me tell you about PETA's highest priority on the Hill today, because PETA really does need your help, every single one of you, to kick this one through the goalpost. It's a bill called the Best Practices Act, which had 94 co-sponsors in the last Congress. BEST stands for Battlefield Excellence Through Superior Training. Operative word, superior. Right now, soldiers go through archaic, brutal trauma training exercises where they are forced to shoot, stab, and even dismember live, writhing animals like goats and pigs. And guess what? A lot of these brave people do not want to do that, which we certainly can understand. It's a trauma for them. They're traumatized by it. This bill would replace the use of animals with high-tech human simulators. These simulators breathe, they bleed, they have a pulse, and they allow the soldiers to repeat and repeat and repeat the procedures until they're truly proficient, something that they can't do with live, writhing animals. And let's face it, pigs have tails, humans don't. To raise the profile of this issue, PETA recruited celebrities including Edie Falco, Marco Raheel, James Cromwell, and Homeland creator Gideon Raff to join their campaign. So please, the minute you get home tonight, unless you've had too many of those very special Sazerac cocktails, in which case, please, you better wait until the morning, we really urge you to contact your representatives, as well as both of your senators, and urge them to co-sponsor the Best Practices Act, and then forward those responses to PETA, because if they're not enthusiastic, if they say no, well, we're gonna know who needs a little persuading. And now I return you to PETA's persuader in chief, my hero, Ingrid Newkirk.
Thank you, Jane, the lovely Jane. Please permit me now to recognize somebody who is not in politics, as far as I know, at all. His name is Gray, he's a fabulous rapper, and he's vegan. Yes!
Take it out.
Wouldn't that be wonderful if they said yes? And finally, a few things that you may not know about some of our past presidents. At PETA, you do know that we often go naked. We protest in the nude. Well, President John Quincy Adams might have joined us, because did you know that every single morning of his presidency, he went into the Potomac in the nude until someone stole his clothes? Abraham Lincoln once said, "I care not for a man's religion whose cat or dog is not the better for it." That's our kind of president. And maybe if he had stayed alive long enough, then he might have freed the animals too. And you remember when Vladimir Putin dissed President George W. Bush's little dog, Barney, who Mary mentioned. And here's what President Bush said, which I think is fabulous. He said, "Anyone who thinks along the lines of, my dog is bigger than your dog, is quite a character." And we agree with that. And finally, President Ulysses S. Grant was an activist, and one day he saw a man beating a horse, and he got down from his carriage and he shook the man with all his might, and he said to him, "If you ever hurt an animal again, I will tie you to a stake and leave you there to rot." That's our kind of president. But I'll take a leaf out of President James Garfield's book, because he knew when to stop talking. So thank you very much. And I think Jane has one thing she told me she wants.
I'm sorry, Ingrid. There's something, we've got some breaking news. We've just learned that candidates running for office in 2016 spent $6.8 billion. And PETA operates on a budget of less than 1% of that. So imagine what PETA could accomplish if they increased their budget just 1%, and we can do that tonight! Can't we? Yes, we can! Now, at every seat on this table, and the tables in front of you, there are envelopes. I ask you right now to pick up those envelopes. Open it up. There is a donation card. There's already a pen there. And I would like you all to change the world for animals. Right now, make a donation to PETA. And guess what? When you do that, you're going to get one of these incredible bunnies, handmade bunnies, with a bipartisan American flag cape on them. And it's going to be delivered to you. So who's going to start? Anna, where? Anna, where? You filled it out. You're going to get one. All right, look who else is going to do this. Okay, we've got some folks over there. We've got people here. Bring those bunnies to them. Raise your hands. There we go. There's another lady and there's a gentleman. We can all do this. Who else wants to change the world? There is nothing more important.
coffee with our